man, Tom Brady of the Patriots. But how about how well these two quarterbacks have played?
Yeah.
Divisional round, then championship games. Foles going throw for throw with Tom Brady. So here we go. First blush of Super Bowl 52, 2 weeks from tonight in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And bring those dog masks. You're going to be a dog again. We know that. And they kind of savor that role right now. How in the world are the Eagles going to beat Tom Brady and the Patriots?
Well, I think they have to do what they did today in terms of defensively. They put pressure on Case Keenum. Every time Case dropped back to throw the football, he was under pressure. And we saw today Jacksonville was able to do that in the first half, but they weren't able to sustain it. You have to be able to sustain it if you want a chance against Tom Brady. And I believe Philly has that, like, they have what it takes to do it.
Well, they have
it.
The depth up front, right?
Right. They have what it takes to do it. It's just being able to get to him and continuously get to him. I don't know if they can do it for an entire game.
Let's give Foles his love and appreciation, because he was awesome. Mm-hmm. He was excellent. Now, when you're looking at a matchup of this magnitude, you start thinking about the quarterbacks first. You want to point them out. Which quarterback is viable to make the first mistake? Normally, it's not Tom Brady. It may be Foles. Then you start thinking about the defenses. Now, the upper hand to me is the defense for Philly. This is the trump card. You know Gronk is going to play. Some kind of rhyme or reason, he's going to play. But let me tell you something, man. Zach Ertz is like a Gronk, but not as physical. He put in some work today. He had 8 targets, 8 receptions, 93 yards today. He was a determining factor today. And it's no answer for him. I don't see an answer for him on New England, as I don't see an answer for Gronk as well with Philly. So I can't wait to see how that inside the number game play out.
Exactly. Ertz actually led the doing it all year.
Yeah, he led the Eagles in catches and receiving yards,
right.
But he didn't get to 1,000 yards. But you know, Bill Belichick's the best at taking what? The best thing that you do away from you.
Yeah.
So the running game's got to be better than it's been so far in the playoffs. Yeah. Everything has got to be ratcheted up a notch, right?
It really does. But, I'm encouraged by what I saw today from the running game for Philly. Mm-hmm. Jay Ajayi, LeGarrette Blount, those guys play well. And even some of the little screen plays to really get them off balance, to get Minnesota off balance, because they rush so well and their defense is so aggressive. I love the play calling. So I believe they can do some of that, get those running backs going. If they do that, man, it'll be a good game, I believe. I don't think it'll be a blowout. I think this will be a really good game.
We didn't think that was going to be a blowout
today. Yeah, that's true.
I want to show you guys one thing. Hey, Winter, take the camera over here if you can zoom in. This is the number of guys on the Eagles roster that have Super Bowl experience. So there's 6 of them.
Ain't nobody can see
that. Here's the Patriots card of the guys that have Super Bowl experience.
That don't mean nothing.
It's 30. There's 33 as opposed to 6.
It don't mean nothing.
Don't think so?
No, it don't mean nothing. It don't mean nothing. It's one game, man. It's one game. It's one game, one night, one day. That's it. It's not like the World Series, you know, where you got several games to play in order to win.
So
this is one.
So you don't think that the Patriots and Jacksonville's game today played a factor in terms of experience versus non-experience?
You know, I think the Patriots-Jacksonville game came down to the quarterback. The quarterback, because when it came down to it, and that was going to be my next point, before Chris jumped in there with that.
with the eye chart?
Yeah, with the eye chart. I memorized that thing, by the way, every time I go there. I can tell you the top 3, but anyway. But let me tell you something. It depends on which quarterback do you think could bounce back from adversity. And I'm not talking about Tom Brady, because you know he can't.
Right.
Now, Ken Foles. Come back from adversity, or when he's down, not saying that he's going to be down, but if he's down by 10, can he wheel that team back into it?
Good question. Mm.
Because that's what happened today. Yeah. All of us sat in the room and said, you know what, man? Blake Bortles is going to have to play some ball right now. Yeah. We're going to get to see who he really is.
Yeah. So there you go, Super Bowl 52.